I'm Iko Halili, and welcome to The Score, where we tackle the hottest and trending topics in sports. After reaching the playoffs at the 2018 PBA Governor's Cup, expectations are high for Blackwater Elite. In just a short span, the Elite have transformed themselves from a struggling expansion team into a legit playoff contender. And with this in mind, the team retooled during the offseason via trades in the PBA draft. Now the question is, can the Blackwater Elite finally make the jump and become a legit title contender in 2019?
New year, new look for the PBA's Blackwater Elite as they try to conquer the 2019 Philippine Cup. The team lost guys like Nard Pinto, Paul Zamar, and JP Heram through trades, but retooled their arsenal in the PBA draft. Blackwater have since acquired young guns Paul Desiderio, Abu Tratter, and Jegodario. Meantime, overall second draft pick Ray Ray Parks will also be taking his talents to the Elite after he finishes his contract in the ABL.
Magtulong-tulungan sa depensa kasi yun ang kailangan naming i-focus ngayon dahil medyo lumiit kami, no? But I believe yung pagkawala nung lumiit sa kami, yung nagagawa ni Eram, eh kayang gampanan nung mga big man ko collectively. Yung mga rookies natin, like Paul Desiderio, I believe he can be a good player, no? A lot of improvement pa na pwedeng may squeeze sa kanya. Ganon din naman si Abu, no? Tratter. I believe they can deliver. Alam ko may role sila na magagampanan sa amin.
Siyempre yung chemistry namin sa team kasi nga bago lang kami, mga bago kami. Kailangan namin maging isa para yun nga, step by step kasi yun eh, para yung team mabuo agad. Kaya unang-una talaga yung chemistry.
Scorers like Mike De Gregorio, Alain Maliksi, Mac Bello will have to take charge this time around.
Gagawin lang namin yung best na ibibigay namin ngayong conference na to, knowing na marami kaming bago, pero malaki naman yung impact na may tutulong nila sa team. Maraming veterans din kami like Mike Cortez na nag-guide sa amin, sila Kuya Alain Maliksi. So, hopefully maganda yung kinalalabasan namin this conference.
And according to head coach Bong Ramos, their defense and attention to small details will be their key in getting more wins this conference.
And joining us today to discuss their preparations for the new season of the PBA, we have Blackwater Elite Spitfire guard Roy Sumang, head coach Bong Ramos, and rookie Abu Tratter. Guys, welcome to The Score.
Good evening, Nico.
Evening, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
I'm glad to have you guys here because in Blackwater Elite, this is a team that's always out to surprise people. Diba? This is not, hindi to parang a San Miguel or a Barangay Ginebra na every time title contender. Blackwater Elite, a personality ng team nyo, you're out to shock, you're out to get upsets. No? What has changed from last season to this season?
Well, actually, medyo malaki yung changes, no? Because nagkaroon nga kami ng retool, no? Nagkaroon kami ng trades. Nawala si Eram sa amin, si Pinto at saka si Paul Sama. But actually we got Abu Tratter and Mike Desiderio with Jego Dario. I believe na si Paul will take the place of Paul Samar, and then yung si Tratter naman can take the place of Poy Eram. Together with the other bigs. Kasi lumiit nga kami ng konti.
Medyo mabigat yun, ha? For Abu, when you hear your coach saying that you're going to fill the shoes of Poy Eram, who is a national team player, who is a sought-after player by many teams, how does that make you feel that you qualify to fill in his shoes?
Well, it makes me feel great, you know, just to have the coach to be able to, you know, have such high remarks for me. But it's also something that I want to take up, you know, as a challenge.
Another challenge, Roy, yun na nga. Medyo tumaas expectations ng tao sa Blackwater Elite. So pagpasok ngayon ng new season, ibig sabihin ba niyan additional pressure para sa inyo?
Siyempre, for me, lagi naman may pressure. Yun lang, yung sinasabi nga lang sa akin ni Coach Bong na magiging challenge din sa'yo tsaka yung responsibility ngayon, lalo na nawala si John sa amin. So ayun, sana magampanan ko yung nagawa ni John last conference sa ngayon conference na dumating sa amin.
Coach, do you feel that when you face teams, iba na yung pagtingin sa inyo? Kasi syempre, you know, pag expansion team ka, talagang maghahabol ka. Medyo maiiwan ka in terms of talent and then syempre the stronger teams. Iba tingin sa inyo. After what you guys did last season, nararamdaman mo ba na iba na pagtingin sa inyo ng ibang PBA teams?
Well, siguro lagi na silang ready to face us, no? Pero syempre, nung nakita nila siguro na medyo lumiit kami, biglang tinitignan na naman kami na medyo maliliit. Kaya nga, they will attack us inside. No? Nasabi nga ni Roy, yung challenge sa kanya, actually, I told Roy na huwag mo nang asahan si Pinto na babalik dito during that time na hindi pa natitrade, but I know na matitrade na. So, sabi ko lang kay Roy, ikaw naman na magte-take over nung ano na yan. Are you ready for that challenge? Sabi ko, that's responsibility. Kasi you have to make your teammates look good all the time. Don't think of yourself. Sabi ko sa kanya, you're the last option all the time.
So kamusta yung ganung klaseng responsibility? Eh, siguro ito yung hinihintay mo sa career mo. Ganitong break, ganitong opportunity, Roy.
So, ayun nga. So, siguro yung first game namin, may mga siguro decision ako na hindi pa ganong okay. So, may adjustment naman eh. Siguro, makapag-adjust ako niyan sa mga ilan games, sa mga sinasabi sa akin ni Coach na yung mga dapat ngang gawin na sometimes kasi yung frustration nga, yun. Ayun siguro yung unang-uno ko dapat baguhin. Lalo na sa akin kasi mabilis ako ma-frustrate.
Pipili ka lang nung panahon pag ilalabas mo si Super Sumang. Diba? So, simula eh. So, di muna natin yung plano ni Coach Bong. Tapos pag dyan na yung tsaka mo ilabas si Super Sumang. Now, Abu, I don't know if you got shocked by the amount of minutes that you had to play in your first game because, well, Coach Bong and the team, they're adjusting to life without a big guy like Poy Aram. So, did you get surprised that you played so many important
minutes.
How many minutes?
37.
Bilang na bilang? 37 minutes.
It was not really a surprise when I was in the game, but, you know, analyzing the game after, I realized, well, wow, I had 35 minutes, you know, because in the game I was full of adrenaline. It's my first game, and just trying to do my job at the best I can. But then coming home, I was really surprised.
And probably tired.
Yeah.
I'm probably tired, but that's a dream come true for a rookie to play 37 minutes in your first game, di ba, Roy?
Yes.
Kung rookie ka, up to 37 minutes, that's like, wow, that's like quite an opportunity, quite a challenge also, and quite the pressure. I mean, don't you feel pressure that, oh my gosh, they're asking me to play 37 minutes and do this and do that in my first year?
Well, yeah, I have a lot of support from the coaching staff and from my teammates, so I didn't really feel too much pressure because they had my back. But, yeah, it's still a little bit of pressure coming in.
Coach Bong, you look at the composition of your team, okay? How excited are you for the Philippine Cup looking at yung materialis that you have?
Actually, yung personnel naman, all of them is a good talent, no? Kailangan lang natin i-squeeze pa ng mabuti and have to play as a team. Excited ako yung doon sa challenge, no? Kasi kailangan kong pukpukin, kailangan kong patakbuhin, di ba? Like to si Abu, I told him when he first arrived, no? I told him, this will be your role. I want you to just play defense. If you can block shots, and take the rebound. If you can make points, you're giving me bonus. And last night, he gave me 18 points. So, may bonus akong 18 points. Although talo kami. But, you know, I was forced to give him more minutes because of what happened to James Sena. Na-injured isang big man ko.
Well, sige, pag-usapan pa natin yung contributions ni Abu and the potential contributions of your other rookies, alright? When the score continues.